Good evening. Today was a sad day for Eddy. You know, I got news today that one of my dearest friends, Steve Tatar, living up there in California, Pennsylvania, passed away this morning. And, you know, before we get started, we are all born, we all go through life, and we meet thousands, and many of us, millions of people around the world. All right, we got acquaintances. It's, hey, how you doing? Hello, what's new? And then you got some people that stick out in your mind and they become lifelong friends. All right, that's what Steve Tatar was to me. Now, all around the world, no matter where you are, we all have people that pass away, family members, friends, acquaintances, you hear it in the news. And, you know, with everything that's going on in the world and everything going on in their professional lives and their personal lives, it always hits home when you hear bad news, especially when someone passes away. And what I'd like to discuss today is my dear friend Steve Tatar. Now, you know, I owned a little store up in Pennsylvania, doing a little locksmithing store. And one day, while I'm in the store, gentleman comes walking in, tall, handsome, nice guy. He says, "Are you Eddy?" I says, "Yes, I'm Eddy." He says, "You know, my name is Steve, and I drive past your place every day, and I see what's going on down here, and I want to, could you teach me to be a locksmith?" He says, "Sure. You know, you seem like a nice guy." He says, "You know, I work up in a place in Uniontown. I can't take it anymore. I see what's going on down here." And you know what? He put his 2 weeks' notice in. He was down at my store 7:30 the next morning. And I set him out. And he started learning the trade. And from that was early 2000. And from that day on, me and him were like best friends. He was almost like, he was a brother to me. All my guys I had working. So over the years, he got his own van, opened up his own Steve's Locksmith. Everyone, all the clients that he had, they all loved him. They always would call me and say, "Eddy, this guy's great. What a personality, very knowledgeable." I said, "You know what? That's what you get when you're with Mr. Sunshine Realtor Eddy." And you know, from that day on, we were always best friends. His dear girlfriend, he had Jamie Stricko. She's a gorgeous girl. I've known her since day one. And over the years, we've always kept in contact. He's always called me once a week. I see him over in Las Vegas. He travels over to Atlantic City. He likes to live life to its fullest. All right? If you picked up the phone 3 a.m, he picks it up and he goes on a job because that's the kind of guy he was. Very successful. And he would always call me and say, "Eddy, I owe it all to you." So today, when I hear this sad news, it brings a pain in my heart. Because I've lost not just a friend, not just a guy, but a true brother. He was like a brother, just like the rest of the guys that worked for me all those years. That's how it goes. And you know, today, you gotta sit there and reflect. I've been sick all day. You know, and I'm trying to compose myself. We're gonna try to get through this without breaking down. But the fact of the matter is, Steve, you were the best guy going. And you know, it is what it is. We all pass on. There's nothing we can do about it. But all we can do is always remember the good times together and everything that was included. You were always a first-class guy. You always wanted to eat the finest food. You always did the best when it came to working. And in your personal life, you are just as fabulous as you were in your professional life. And in closing, I want you to know that I'm always going to miss you. I'm going to miss seeing your phone call. And from what I understand from a friend of mine, Sean Nick, I guess you guys saw each other Thursday up at a Walmart. And the whole conversation was about yours truly. You know, I was hoping you were planning on coming down here to sunny South Florida, you and Jamie, spend a week with me, take you around town and eat the filet mignons just the way you ate them in Vegas. Because that's how it goes. So in closing, I want everybody to know, your friends that you have, you never know when you're going to get that call and they're gone. You understand? So what you make sure you're blessed every day with the friends you have. You make sure you pick up the phone and say, hey, I hope all is good. And because you never know when you get the call and they say, you know what, we got bad news today. So I hope you all have yourself a great day. I hope you be blessed with the friends and family you have. Enjoy them, because once they're gone, they're never coming back. They're always going to be in your memory. They're always going to be in your mind. But the fact remains, enjoy them while they're still alive on Earth. So I'm going to play a little music. I got a little thing going on here. In about 3 minutes, I hope you all have a fantastic day.
A lot of people's going to miss you, Steve. I love you, buddy.